Hey everybody, the Banga is back. Welcome to part 8 of Let's Play Sphinx and the Cursed Mummy. Alright, so what we just did is we got the Capture Beetles by way of... Well, we had to find Anubis, and by being able to capture 3 enemies, we were able to put in some work. Wait, detonate? That doesn't set him on fire, though. I got the Capture Beetles, but how do I use the monsters myself? So I know there's a way you can do it. I thought I could actually just use the fire armadillos. Or you know what? Maybe I don't have them anymore. Did I give them to Anubis? Yeah, I think I gave them to Anubis. That might be what it is, yeah. Alright, so let me just go up again. Because I can use those fire armadillos to get the boxes. And we should go to the Cursed Palace soon after. So now it would be pretty much be a good idea to find monsters and actually not kill them. Okay, now they show up in your inventory now. Wait. Oh, there we go. That's what you have to do. And they just killed themselves. Well, it just killed itself. And sadly, I don't have it anymore. So they do go away after a while. Now, I don't know if you can just capture it again. But that would probably be a waste of beetles. Are you kidding me? I'm gonna die, aren't I? That would be embarrassing if I die now. Alright, let me just capture one more armadillo and we'll be on our way. Now the real question is, can I pick up any more of these? Like, can I pick up more capture beetles for later? Or am I just screwed for a while until I find where I can get them? Because they don't seem to be anything you can just pick up. Sphinx! I hear you have convinced Anubis to free some of the people of the Cursed Palace. I hate to admit it, but I was wrong about you. I admire your bravery and compassion for those poor people. You've proved yourself my equal. In demonstration of my goodwill, I have decided to give you a present. This is no ordinary gift. It is the Dark Stone of Invisibility. It grants the power of invisibility to any person that uses it. I am sure it will be very useful in your future quests. I hope you can forgive my arrogance towards you in the past. I apologize, Sphinx. Why just give this to me? Don't use it! It's a trap! You guys might have heard my phone there. I gotta remember to, like, actually turn the ringer off when I record these. That really is the Dark Stone of Invisibility. But the power of invisibility has a nasty side effect. It causes instant death. Of course, Tutankhamun will be able to use it without danger to himself. Keep the stone for now. We will send it to our friend the mummy when we get the opportunity. I'm afraid you must not trust Horus any further. Jealousy of your achievements has clearly affected his judgment. Who knows his true motives? Perhaps his survival in Uruk was not simply a matter of good fortune. It's a bit of a crude thing to say, but alright, I'll take your word for it. Alright, even though I could use my fire armadillo now, thing is, I really need some health. And good to know there was like a lot of onks. I guess I'm just not good at this. Wait, where'd my beetle go? Did it just up and disappear? I had no idea what happened. Like, I just threw it around and all of a sudden it was gone. Oh well, in any case, I got a second armadillo. So, now that we can actually release a couple people, let's go to the Cursed Palace. You know that fire armadillo would actually be pretty good up there. So if I remember correctly, wasn't there a boulder on like some, like a wooden scaffolding? If I burn it down, burn it down. Look at me, I sound like a chud. We would be able to maybe take down some of those Eyes of Ra. But first, let's go to the Cursed Palace. We still gotta save a couple people. Plus, when I'm lucky, I might be able to get some more health. Oh, wait a minute! You can capture beetles in these pots! Oh, that's a game changer! Okay, so let's take a look at these cursed stones. Okay, associated with fertility, so that's for red. Mightier than the sword, so that's for yellow. Therefore, I can't just put it here. Wait, can I? That stone is the wrong color, so no. I guess you can't really do that. Therefore, I have to find something in red. Or in yellow. I suppose this will work, right? Oh no, that's actually white. Alright, here's red. Alright, you're now free.
What's going on here? Where am I? Wait a minute. This is the Pharaoh's Palace. How in the world did I get here?
Of course. I was called to work on the palace gardens. I don't recognize any of these other people, though. I thought the Pharaoh had banned all visitors. I wonder how he will feel when he sees all these stoned people everywhere. Anyway, I don't know. Stoned? Anyway, I should get back to the farm and find my brother. He must be very worried about me. Thanks for freeing me, my friend. Oh god, I hope you're not gonna go straight to the farm with all those eyes.
You should come by the farm. It's just up the hill outside here. Come and see us and we'll help you if we can.
Alright, it looks like by rescuing some of the people in the Cursed Temple, I'm able to get more things available to use. That's actually really beneficial. And therefore, it should be in my best interest to save everyone. Now, let's just use the capture armadillo now. Oh! Look, another Atun Eye! Okay. How many of these do I have? Do I have two already? Yes, I have two! So I can get rid of another statue. Well, luckily I know where I can get some more fire armadillos later. Therefore, I should probably consider filling up my stock of them when I get the chance. Anyway, here's the second cursed stone ready to be used. Hey, Poindexter. What the? What is this strange place? What? You surprised me there, stranger. I was summoned from Abydos to write the Pharaoh's autobiography when I started to feel ever so sleepy. Next thing I know, here I am with you. These strange events have given me a great idea for a gripping new book. I'm going back to Abydos immediately to start work on it. Thank you for your help, stranger. Take this book of mine as a gift. When you're in Abydos, don't hesitate to drop by for a chat. Toodlepip! The Book of the Dead. With this ancient tome, you can summon Basket to transport canopic vases to the mummy. Oh, that will actually be very important later. Seems that we need those vases to save a soul. Oh, I can capture that scorpion. Blade scorpion, nice. Wonder what it does. Oh, it shows up under monsters, I guess. Fire armadillo, damaging any opponents with scorching results. Blade scorpion is quick on its feet and quicker to attack. Beware of its tail and the darkened hidey holes it favors for sleeping. Hey, you even get their stats, too. That's hilarious. Captured ones can be used to burn down wooden obstacles. That is true. I like to keep the... I'll just keep the one that I have for now. And I'm not worried gonna burn every single crate yet. I'll deal with that later when I have more of these armadillos. The most amount of capture beetles I can have, by the way, is 20. So once I get some spare time between episodes, I should fill up on as much armadillos as I need. Hey. There you are! Thank you so much! I really can't thank you enough for freeing my brother. I was getting desperate. I thought I would never see him again. But thanks to you, we're reunited. Oh, that was your son. My brother and I would love to get back to the farm, but not while those deadly eyes of Ra are out there. Yeah, it looks like our misfortune is set to stay with us. Oh, don't be so negative. Let me take care of it. Because that's what a hero does. He'll just take his sweet-ass time doing it. I wonder if I, like, destroy all those skulls. Are they only just speed platforms? Or... those speed panels? I don't know. I guess we'll find out later, as I free up another set. Okay, let's give this a try. Wrong button! Get out of the way! Oh, yeah, they just die. Smashing secrets. Ooh. That could be worth my while as well. Just found a random treasure chest. Well, that's nice to find too. Not gonna dispute that in the slightest. Whoa, 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 whoa! Well, at least the treasure chest is still there. I didn't think I was in its range at the time. You got a Gold Ankh piece. Like four of these, and a person with the right skills to be able to increase your health capacity. And that's my second one. Looks like I'll need to find a couple more if I'm gonna be able to get a health upgrade. Ah, well. You know what? I can actually shoot those targets. But first, I'm gonna go ahead and dismantle another one of those skulls. There's a random tornado over there. I don't know why. Oops. I keep forgetting it's this button. Use the Eye of Atun over here. Use the Eye of Atun over here. Oh, it is a speed panel! I mean, I certainly don't mind, but still, I thought it was gonna be something different. So I'm guessing I should probably just go back to the temple and help out the mummy. Yeah, I think that's what I should do. But, seeing how I'm here, Why don't we go get some more fire armadillos and break the rest of those crates in Cursed Temple? At least I don't even have to go all the way over here. Maybe I'll have to make some more progress in the game to get, like, more Cursed Stones from Anubis? Oh, the beetles don't last in water. Okay. Got one. At least they'll keep respawning. Ow! Rude! I didn't say you could just go up and do that. Let me get one more. Just for precaution. It's like I hate when they hit you without actually doing an attack. What is this, Mario? Okay, three should be enough. So let's take care of the rest of those crates. And I think another thing we should do after that is go shoot those targets. That means I have to re-equip the blow dart gun. That should not be an issue. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a Steam achievement for getting, like, all these Atuan eyes used. Don't worry, I'm coming. I got more important things to worry about, like possibly getting more Scarab Beetles. Might get an Atuan eye out of that, too. I don't know. But if it's just beetles, then I feel like I wasted my time. Wait, do the crates come back? I'm not sure. More gold scarabs. Hey, wait a minute. My capacity is 400. Maybe I shouldn't buy any more just yet. Or get any more, I should say. Yeah, I should probably wait until maybe I have, like, less money. Or maybe I have the ability to carry more money later. So, why don't we go back to the blowpipe? Okay, this should not be too hard. I gotta hit three targets, right? That is, if those targets are easy to hit and I don't have to worry about a time limit. So maybe if I stand over here, that should be ideal, right? Oh, that actually hit! Oh, they deactivate after a while. Okay, that's gonna be irritating. Alright, let me try standing over here. Oh, you know what? You can only hit it on certain sides. Like, I think you can only hit it on the side that's glowing. So maybe if I'm standing here, that would be perfect. But let me stand somewhere where I probably don't have to worry about being out of range for one. That's the wrong button. Did I get them all? Yes, I did. Ah, another treasure chest. Okay. Not bad. Oh, look, it's another Gold Ankh piece. That's 3 in total. I can't really say I like it, but I think I'm gonna have to try the obstacle course again. I think that's probably gonna be the last thing I do in this episode, and then we'll cap it off. That sounds about fair, right? I'm still not a fan, because I kept getting my ass owned in the obstacle course. And I keep getting so close, but not close enough. Now, if only I could find some monsters to capture that are explosive. If I can do that, I might be able to dismantle the other, raw eyes. I'm gonna try it out again. No, I don't wanna hear your rules. To hell with your rules. Okay, I'm gonna try to be as fast as I can doing this stuff. Oh, I keep forgetting you can't grab the zip line in the middle. I hate that. Because there are some other games where you can just grab it in the middle and it's fine. This one's not one of them. Again, I just wish you could have see a timer. Sadly, that's not the case at all. I wish I could make this go a little bit faster. But you can't. So you're at the mercy of this one's very slow speed. If I try to drop too early, I'm probably gonna fall in the water. So there's very little room for error in this. See? What'd I tell ya? But it said I could somersault. So maybe I should just drop early and then do the somersault. Oh man, I almost had a bad camera angle for this. Yeah, I think that's what I should do. Just like, drop. Drop a little bit early. And then somersault as soon as I can. Because at least I'll be able to still get forward momentum. Just hope it works. This one's just a pain in the ass. Like, again, I just wish I could see my time. Wow. That was stupid. I had to wait anyway. Oh shit, I think I messed up. Oh, I might make it! I might make it! Did I make it? What's my time? What? How can you be back already? You must have cheated! 77 seconds! That is amazing! Such a time deserves a reward. Here, take this. May it bring you good health on your journey. Ha! Gold Ankh piece number 4. Collect 4 of these and a person with the right skills. Well, I have 4 of them! Acrobatic Ease achievement. Finally, I got that one done. So I don't have to worry about it ever again. Unless I want to show off. But do I really want to do that? I don't think so. You know, another thing I could do is head back to Abydos. And see what has changed, because I don't know one guy came back. Alright, so I think that's a decent amount of progress to make up for probably not my best video, even though I had progress made. I was just a bit clumsy. But in any case, let's stop the video here, and in the next part, I should probably either go back to Abydos, see what I can do, or head back to the temple. You know, like, or rather, the Sun Shrine. See you later, everyone. Thanks for watching.